Hi there, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this video, I'm gonna talk about which MBNA MasterCards is good for traveling, and that video is gonna come up right now. Did you know there's 14 different MasterCards with MBNA? However, with those 14 MasterCards, there's really only 5 MasterCards with MBNA that is good for travel. The first one is the MBNA Platinum Plus Rewards MasterCard. And this card will earn you 5,000 points after spending $500 within 90 days. You'll also earn another 5,000 points after enrolling in paperless e-statements. And you'll earn 4 points for every dollar spent on groceries, restaurants, and gasoline for the first 90 days of having this card. After 90 days, you'll earn 2 points for every dollar spent on groceries, gas, or restaurants. For all other purchases, you will earn 1 point for every dollar spent. Now, the points multiplier does have a hard cap of $5,000 every year, and this card also has no annual fee. Now, for this credit card, for every 100 points that you have, that is equivalent to $1. So basically, 1,000 points is equivalent to $10, which is very similar to a lot of other credit cards, such as the Cobalt card with American Express or the Scotia Rewards American Express. And I think this is a decent deal because essentially that 10,000 points that you earn is equivalent to $100. And because the card has no annual fee, then that's an easy $100 towards travel that you can use. So my verdict for this card is it's not bad. It's not the best, but it's not bad. The next card on the list is the MBNA Rewards World Elite MasterCard. And for this card, you will earn 20,000 points for spending $2,000 within your first 90 days. You'll also earn 10,000 points after enrolling in e-statements. And this card does have a very big income requirements of $80,000 for personal or $150,000 for household. You'll also earn 5 points for every dollar spent on restaurants, groceries, digital media, memberships, and utilities. Now, that 5 points bonus for every dollar spent does have a hard cap of $50,000 per year. For all other purchases outside those categories, you're gonna earn 1 point for every dollar spent. You'll also earn a bonus of 10% of your points every time it's your birthday. And basically how they calculate that is 12 months before your birthday, they'll take all the points that you have and give you 10% worth of all the points that you've earned. There is a maximum cap of 15,000 points that you can earn. So basically, from the sound of it, the maximum amount that you can spend is $150,000 to get that maximum amount of 15,000 points. The card does have an annual fee of $120, and the worth of those points is basically 100 points is equivalent to $1, or 1,000 points is $10. So basically, because you're paying $120 in annual fee, then 12,000 of your points is gonna go towards canceling out that annual fee. That means you still have 18,000 points to play with that you can use towards travel. Overall, I think this card is not bad, but I would not say this is the best travel credit card in Canada if you're only planning to get one or two credit cards with MBNA. The next one on the list is the Alaska Airlines World Elite MasterCard. For this card, you're gonna earn 30,000 Alaska miles after spending $1,000 within your first 90 days. The card also has a $99 annual fee, but if you apply through Great Canadian Rebates, you're gonna get $50 back. I'll put that referral link to the Great Canadian Rebates in the description below, so check that out if you wanna go sign up and get that $50 rebate when signing up for the Alaska Airlines MasterCard. The credit card also has a bigger annual income requirement of $80,000 for personal or $150,000 for household. You also get a companion fare where the second person that travels with you is only gonna pay $121 US, and this is only valid on Alaska Airlines flights, not on their partners. I think this perk is really good because if you travel during peak season, for example, I personally use it during the Christmas season and the flight was about $400 one way. And instead of paying $800 for me and my girlfriend, we ended up paying around $500 for our flight going from Hawaii back to Vancouver, Canada, which is a savings of about $300, which is pretty good. You also get 3 miles for every dollar spent with Alaska Airlines and 1 point for every dollar spent on everything else. You also get a complimentary check bags on qualifying reservations. And if you're wondering what is 30,000 Alaska miles worth, well, I would say it's roughly worth $350 if you're flying in economy, because I did a quick check on a flight between Montreal and Dublin, Ireland, and it's $350 one way. So this is a better value than the MBNA rewards points that you earn, because for that one, the amount of points that you have will not get you as much in terms of dollar value compared to the Alaska miles. With that being said, if you have 60,000 Alaska miles, then it's no longer worth $350. It's closer to $2,000 because you can book it on business class. So really, the Alaska miles, their value increases exponentially if you're booking it in a higher class. And in my opinion, this is the best card with MBNA. I'll still do the review of the other cards, but if you can get this card, this is definitely the best one to get. The next one on the list is the MBNA Alaska Airlines Platinum Plus MasterCard. For this card, you're gonna earn 20,000 Alaska miles for spending $1,000 within your first 90 days. The annual fee is $75, but if you apply through Great Canadian Rebates, you're going to get $50 back. I'll put the referral link to the Great Canadian Rebates in the description below, so check that out if you want to get that $50 rebate. The nice thing about this card is there's no income requirements, so pretty much anyone in Canada can get this card. You'll also earn 3 points for every dollar spent on Alaska Airlines and 1 point for every dollar spent on everything else. You'll also get the $121 companion fare. That's US dollars, by the way. And again, that's a really good perk to use if you want to fly during peak season. And overall, I think this card is really good. So if you can't get the World Elite version, this is the next best thing to get. And the last travel credit card with MBNA is the Best Western MasterCard. For the MBNA Best Western MasterCard, you're gonna earn 20,000 Best Western points after your first purchase, and there's no annual fee for this credit card. However, if you apply through Great Canadian Rebates, you're gonna get $50 cash back. So again, I'll put the referral link down below if you wanna apply for this card and get that rebate. You'll also earn 5 points for every dollar spent with Best Western and 1 point for every dollar spent on everything else. Now, what is the Best Western points worth? Well, I would say it's worth about $100 for every 10,000 points, because roughly that's how much it costs to get one free night in a hotel. Again, it depends on which country you redeem your points, but I do think the Best Western points is really good for staying in hotels, especially outside Canada. So I do think this is a very good value in terms of getting free night stay in a hotel. Now, this card is just okay compared to the Marriott Bonvoy credit cards with American Express in terms of getting a free night hotel stay. The good perk about this card is there's no annual fee, and really it's the only hotel credit card that you can get with MBNA. So really this card stands out a little bit better just because it's purely for Best Western properties. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to the Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world. You'll also get the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up for the newsletter in the description below. Until next time, I'll see you then.